we have now witnessed the President of the United States operating outside the bounds of U.S. law and the tradition of what we know to be our democracy, which is the United States government does not use the military against civilians in this country unless there's a damn good reason. And this just wasn't a damn good reason. And well, also, all we ended up with was what the President of the United States looking like a wannabe dictator. Right. So he could walk over to a church and pretend to be concerned about the church. It was it's just a sad, unbelievable thing.
It's like in some small country that's taken over by some low-level lieutenant, you know, low-level colonel.
Anderson Cooper sounds stupid. I tell him that to his face. Anderson Cooper sounds stupid.
I think, Anderson, one of the things that has to be remembered in all of this is that President Trump, Donald Trump, did not do this by himself tonight. There were other White House officials, military officials, federal employees paid for with our tax dollars, and our tax dollars were used to tear gas fellow Americans.
Brett, moments ago, the U.S. Park Police put out a statement saying that no tear gas was used during that pushback of protesters in Lafayette Square this time last night.
As if the people in these areas protesting are enemy targets. They're not. They're American citizens. Right. And on top of that, you asked about the attorney general. I snapped a picture of the president walking out with Jared and Ivanka and all of these officials. And Bill Barr, the U.S. attorney general, had a big smile on his face.
Of course.
Why is he smiling after they cleared a park of protesters out of there with tear gas? It's just it's hard to wrap your head around.
That no tear gas was used during that pushback of protesters.
Our tax dollars were used to tear gas fellow Americans. That's what happened tonight in the nation's capital, and the entire world was watching.
Can you stay categorical?
You are fake news.
I also want to address a few other matters that have been raised about that evening. First, National Guard forces did not fire rubber bullets or tear gas into the crowd, as reported.
Peaceful demonstrators.
Shock and outrage. Those are the words being used after tear gas was used to remove peaceful protesters from Washington's Lafayette Park.
Peaceful protests turned violent.
Peaceful protesters being gassed.
Thousands of peaceful protesters.
Police and the National Guard used flashbang explosives and tear gas in order to disperse a crowd that had been peacefully protesting in front of the White House.
Police cleared a park of peaceful protesters by using tear gas and rubber bullets so President Trump could walk through.
Police firing tear gas and pepper spray at peaceful protesters.
After that tear gas went off, around 6:30, protesters had been largely peaceful.
Cleared that park of peaceful protesters with tear gas.
It was by far the most peaceful day of protest.
Hold on. This tear gas is now being fired. You can see what's going on.
Well, Steve, I think the streets are quieter now because of the mounted police and the tear gas.
Clearly, they don't want these protesters to be there, even though they were peaceful. They were just screaming a little bit.
To violently clear the streets of peaceful protesters.
Washington, D.C., flashbangs and tear gas were used to disperse protesters in Lafayette Park.
To clear what has been an entirely peaceful protest.
As he spoke, you can hear the sounds of tear gas canisters popping off in the background.
Is the president declaring war on Americans?
Tear gas everywhere.
But they were not endangering anyone, and all of a sudden, tear gas and at least
flashbangs, tear gas. I lost my regular mask and had to replace it with my gas mask.
First the flashbangs, then the tear gas.
Forcefully started clearing people out using tear gas.
And even the people who were running and actively trying to get out of the way were getting hit by tear gas or rubber bullets.
Peaceful protests turned violent.
Joe Biden in a church, praying, meeting with local black leaders, talking about injustice and how to help. And the other of President Trump standing in front of a church, holding a Bible that he had to clear out peaceful protesters by tear gas to get to that photo op.
While peaceful, law-abiding citizens were exercising their constitutional right to protest in a public park across from the White House, President Trump ordered federal troops to clear those peaceful crowds with tear gas and rubber bullets so that he could trudge a few blocks from the White House to stand in front of a church, not to go inside, but for a photo op.
Yesterday, we saw a most unfortunate situation where before the curfew, the time of the curfew occurred, peaceful demonstrators in front of protesters in front of the White House were beaten. Some people came out and beat them so they could clear the area so the president could come out and go forward. What is that? That has no place. And it's time for us to do away with that. A time to heal.
Do you think it's good or was good for the president to order people to use tear gas, rubber bullets?
Well, I think let's be clear on the question of the tear gas. The park police have issued a statement earlier today and then just one just now before we became on air. They said tear gas was not used, and they want to be clear about that.
When peaceful protesters dispersed an order for a president from the doorstep of the people's house, the White House, using tear gas and flash grenades in order to stage a photo op.
The media is sour now because they were forced to shoot a photo op of the president of the United States demonstrating that he's not going to be intimidated by criminals. It was a very powerful moment for the country, and they're bitter that they had to film it because it deals a big blow to their lawless side.
As police move in, they fire tear gas on the crowd. While inside the grounds of the White House, a remarkable split screen.
After the gas came the horses, a modern-day cavalry with clearing the battlefield. The purpose? So President Trump could wave a Bible, not read a Bible, not even his Bible, as a prop. The President of the United States ordered troops to attack peaceful American citizens, exercising their constitutional rights by tear gassing them in a public park.
Tear gas was not used, and there will probably be hearings about this. Capitol Hill's already doing that.
You're saying these were peaceful protesters? You mean the same protesters that lit the church on fire the last night? The same protesters that smashed all these windows all over Washington? The same protesters that threw a bottle at the attorney general an hour before? Dana mentioned the park police commission just came out. He said they found stashed baseball bats and glass bottles. And they warned them three times to disperse because curfew was just around the corner. They didn't. They continued to throw bottles. So they threw some smoke bombs out and pushed them back. Wow. Armageddon, really? This is what we're talking about. This is a church next to the White House. It needs to be protected. It's sacred ground. If the people hadn't been pushed back one block, they would have been throwing bottles at the President of the United States. Is that what everybody wants? You trust this mob, Juan? You trust this mob that's burned the whole country down, that's looted the whole country, that a night before set fire to a church? You trust them to be within a block of the president? I don't trust these people at all. At this point, they've shown no ability to be trusted at this point. Killing cops now, punching people in the face for no reason. They're trying to protest violence against an innocent man, and yet they're committing violence on innocent men and women. It's disgusting. This country's had enough of it, and this fake scandal is just another frame job of the president. Well, the rest of the country agrees with everything he did.
24 to 72 hours before you retweet anything by the left-wing media, it's probably a hoax, and you'll save yourself a lot of embarrassment. If you didn't hear it on Fox, ignore it. I'm not kidding. It's usually a hoax. Stupid stuff.
I wish you were kidding, but as you say, fake news and dumb news. Fake and dumb. All too over. Much for me.
Looking ahead in the first 100 days of my presidency, I've committed to creating a National Police Oversight Commission. I've long believed we need real community policing.
let me tell you something. Joe Biden today called for sweeping police reform. But during his administration, Eric Garner, Michael Brown, Tamir Rice, Freddie Gray, Sandra Bland, they all died during he and Barack Obama's administration. And he didn't call for sweeping police reform then. This harvest that we're receiving now, this frustration that the black community is having now, it's based upon seeds that were sown during the prior administration. If George Floyd is the last straw, then the first, second, third, and fourth straw all came up under Obama's administration, and they didn't have this degree of outrage. They were not trying to accuse the president or hold the president culpable for actions of individual policemen.
Absolutely. What the heck? What did Joe Biden do for the African-American community in 30-plus years? And then 8 years as vice president.
Pelosi, Biden, all these characters have been in power for decades. In all these cities that are being burned on fire, 99% of them are controlled by liberal, the most far left-wing liberal Democrats who have controlled it as a one-party state for decades.